time for a very special Thursday show.
Someone's listening to me. Now I know how a radio feels.
Hollywood stars like Olivia Wilde, Natalie Portman, Ellen DeGeneres, and wife Portia de Rossi have all sworn off animal products in favor of a vegan diet.
Let's start off first with the proteins. What are some of the ways that vegans replace protein from meat?
There are ways of getting protein in a vegan diet.
And there's nothing worse than a vegan turning up at a barbecue. You know, when you go, here, there's burgers, sausages. Oh, I'm a vegan.
I'm a yo-yo dieter. Yo, hot dog man. Yo, peanuts. Why aren't you laughing? Don't you know what yo means?
Hi, everybody, and welcome to NSS. This is the Reynolds Report. Roger Federer shocked the tennis world yesterday when he announced he's pulling out of the Olympics and will miss the rest of the season due to a knee injury. Federer announced on his Facebook page that his left knee needs extensive rehabilitation, and doctors advised him to sit out the rest of the season. We told you back in March that the Late Late Show's James Corden, hoping for a carpool karaoke spinoff show, well, it became official yesterday when Apple bought the rights to the series. Apple will distribute the show on Apple Music. The series will consist of 16 episodes. In each episode, celebrities will ride along and sing along with James Corden. Each week, a new episode will become available exclusively to Apple Music subscribers in more than 100 countries. A host for the new series and a premiere date will be announced later, with production scheduled to begin soon. Now that Hillary Clinton is the official Democratic nominee for president, I think it's time to update her most famous political ad for the 2016 campaign.
It's 3 a.m. and your children are safe and asleep. But there's a phone in the White House and it's ringing. Something's happening in the world. Your vote will decide who answers that call. Whether it's someone who already knows the world's leaders, knows the military, someone tested and ready to lead in a dangerous world.
Hi, is Bill there?
Who do you want answering the phone?
The Kremlin says the idea that Russia hacked the DNC emails is absurd. In other words, the Kremlin definitely hacked the DNC emails. The world's deepest underwater sinkhole has been located in the South China Sea. Experts say it's so deep it could hold almost all of Hillary Clinton's deleted emails. The jerk who created the girl group USA Freedom Kids to perform at Donald Trump rallies is now suing the campaign for failure to live up to its promise of promoting the group's recording career. Right, because there's nothing today's teens love more than listening to pre-adolescent girls sing about the political beliefs of a billionaire senior citizen. For the sixth consecutive year, Iceland has been named the world's most peaceful country. Apparently, they don't have elections there. Airport security in Dallas says it's beefed up measures since a guy without a ticket or ID was able to board a plane recently. They've figured out how he did it. Of course, they haven't figured out how he was able to taxi the plane down the runway. A 57-year-old man in Oregon was arrested once cops learned he was behind his own kidnapping in order to extort money from his senior citizen mother. If that didn't work, his plan B was to hold his breath until he got his own way. The first completely solar-powered airplane flight around the world was made official Tuesday. The journey took over a year. It normally wouldn't take that long, but the plane had to keep avoiding North Korean missiles, disputed Chinese islands, and every 12-year-old boy's toy drone. Los Angeles is only the 85th smartest city in the U.S., bringing the score down. All those people in Los Angeles who actually think they'll make it in show business. TV psychic Miss Cleo has passed away at the age of 53, though her family says she went out doing what she loved, bilking gullible old people out of their retirement savings. Time for Nobody Gives a F***. Starbucks will now let baristas wear fedoras, which is good, because the main problem with Starbucks baristas is their glaring lack of insufferable hipsterness. Hey, baristas, nobody gives a F***. A Mormon leader is building a utopian settlement in Vermont. If only I could fit Coldplay into this scenario, it would be the world's whitest sentence ever. Hey, Utopia, nobody gives a f***. and 94% of Apple Watch owners are satisfied. And by satisfied, I mean douchebags. Hey, Apple, nobody gives a f***. Thanks, everybody. We have a new episode of The Reynolds Report for you every weekday. Be sure to check out The Being Frank Show, starring Frank D'Angelo, live Tuesdays and Thursdays right here on NSS.